Sat Sri Akal, Ross Robertson. Mr. Speaker, Sat Sri Akal, Dr. G. You called everyone with their salam, but you didn't address me, so we are exchanging the great greetings now. I stand to support this Identification Information Confirmation Bill on the first reading. As Dr. Ashar Chaudhary has just mentioned few cases, I think they are very relevant in today's world. In recent times, we have seen many cases of fake identities. We need to stop this, and I think it is most important and appropriate time to pursue this bill. Under the present Privacy Act 1993, government agencies have access to match information about individuals, whether it is accurate or not, but the private sector have limited access to such information. They were not able to confirm if this information provided by their clients is correct or not. The protection of identity is very important in today's age. The purpose of this bill is to help combat identity fraud. In this modern day and age, this is a real problem. We hear in news regularly of people being hounded for debts of which they have absolutely no idea how this came about. What this bill does is, with the consent of an individual, both private and public sector agencies could check identity information held on government database, such as information held by registrar of passport, citizen and birth, death, marriage certificate and civil marriage registrar. To combat this misuse of this facility, the Identity Information Bill offers the use of web-based data validation service to public and private sector on strictly need-to-know basis. Data validation permit agencies to check whether the identity information produced by a customer is consistent and reliable with that held by the Department of Internal Affairs through the Citizenship Registrar or any other registrar they have. This bill also allows banks and other financial institutions to carry out more dependable assessment on customers' required loans. This extends the application and compliance of Anti-Money Laundering and Countering Finance of Terrorism Act 2009. On the other hand, the government is fully aware of privacy concerns. The consent of the customer is paramount. The customer is not compelled to consent to this background check. Personal information is protected, and data validation service only confirms the accuracy concern that person's information. It does not reveal any other personal information. This bill also protects privacy in other ways. The Privacy Commissioner will have the authority to compel the department to provide report to her on the operation of the service. This is to monitor the consistency of the information delivered to various agencies, as they will need to demonstrate a genuine need for this service. These organizations will also be listed on the department's website. The Identity Information Confirmation Bill has also introduced a solution to our modern time. The national-led government has assessed this problem and has acted promptly. Mr. Speaker, this bill will help in the prevention of crime, particularly identity-related crime, and will also ensure that public agencies can use and, if necessary, record criminal identity information. To protect the privacy of personal information, any agency using this service will need to enter this agreement with the Chief Executive of Department of Internal Affairs at the registrars of birth and death and marriages or both. The private agencies will have limited ability to check whether the identity provided to them is correct or not. I commend this bill to the House. Dr.